In this two-part module, we examine the approach of Standard & Poor's to the assessment of credit risk for banks. We review the principal publications by S&P on the subject, examine the more critical calculations they require, and illustrate how the S&P guidelines are applied to specific banks around the world. This module consists of 6 chapters, with chapters 1, 2, and 3 appearing in part 1, and chapters 4, 5, and 6 appearing in part 2. In part 1, chapter 1 provides a roadmap that summarizes the S&P methodology and prepares you for the more detailed and very technical discussion that follows in the remaining 5 chapters. Still in part 1, chapter 2 describes the methodology behind S&P's determination of the economic risk component of its so-called BICRA, or Banking Industry Country Risk Assessment. Still in part 1, chapter 3 describes the methodology behind S&P's determination of the industry risk component of its BICRA. In part 2, chapter 4 describes S&P's methodology for the assessment of a bank's capital position under its ratings criteria. Chapter 5 examines the next steps in S&P's bank rating methodology, which take us from the determination of the BICRA group to the so-called standalone credit profile, or SACP. Chapter 6, finally, discusses the degree of ratings uplift that S&P recognizes when sovereigns are likely to provide support to a bank in a crisis, and the extent to which the likelihood of such support allows S&P to raise the rating for the bank above its SACP.